Guys, welcome back to Jamie Allen Golf. What we want to talk about today is the old technique using hitting a chip shot and the new technique, how to perform a chip shot, how hopefully that's going to improve your golf. So the old method was where the ball position was a little bit too far back, hands miles forward, almost in this position, and weight was miles forward, and from there, if I was to hit the golf ball from that angle, then what's going to happen is I'm not actually going to make consistent contact with the golf ball. So I'm almost in that position, and I'm going to, because when we're in that position, we almost don't expose much of the bounce. So this part of the golf club is called the leading edge. The leading edge is almost digging into the ground, hit down it, ball goes generally too low. So this part of the golf club is called the leading edge. We almost dig this part into the ground, which is generally going to reduce the loft on the club, and it's going to hit the ball into the ground. You're not going to gain a lot of consistency. The next thing we want to focus on is where the club is interacting with the ground and how we need to improve that. So if we move the ball position back, then what happens is we create a lot of shaft lean. So the shaft is miles ahead of the club head, and from there it's actually very difficult for us to generate a lot of consistency. So if the handle goes too far forward, then what tends to happen is we tend to back off, keep our weight on the right foot to almost just try and hit the golf ball. So moving the ball position back is not going to create a lot of consistency. So if we move this handle miles forward, then we're going to take a lot of divots behind the golf ball, and from there we almost have to get our weight back. The thing I was related to is trying to get the grip of the club to be kind of in line with your zip on your jacket. From that position, the hands are miles forward, the hands are the grip's miles ahead of the zip on my jacket, and then from there, for me to get the handle to move back, I have to flip or get my weight to go back to the right. So miles forward, ball's miles back, weight's miles forward. So from there, see how my chest's almost too far ahead of the golf ball. What happens is, if I was to hit in that position, I'm going to hit miles behind the ball. So what do? I move my weight back to try and hit the golf ball, to try and almost not take a divot. Let's try that again. So I'm almost not exposing anything at all. I'm not exposing the bounce at all. So here I've got 9-iron, but this is just an example. So if I put my ball position back, or the ball position back, hands forward, I'm going to hit into the ground. And what's going to happen is the ball's going to shoot off low, and I'm generally not going to allow the bounce or the sole of the club to hit the ground. So think about, this part of the club is designed to interact with the ground. We're not using this part, so we're getting this part, the bottom of the club, to interact with the ground. So take a couple of practice swings, almost just try and feel like that you're hearing the bounce or the bottom of the club just trying to hit the ground. So almost in that position, we're not digging in like that. So we're not digging in like that. We're almost just allowing the sole of the club to hit off the ground or ricochet off the ground. Getting the hands slightly more level with our body. Ball position a little bit further forward and not as much weight on our front foot. So think about our weights evenly distributed. And what we're going to do from there is we're going to allow the sole of the club to interact with the ground. Hear that bounce off the ground. The old way we mentioned that the ball was miles back in our stance. Hands were miles forward, weights so far ahead of the ball. From there, for us to hit the golf ball, we're just going to dig the leading edge into the ground. So what we do is we psychologically think, right, I need to get quite good contact here. So what you do is you start moving your weight onto your back foot, and then the leading edge of the ground starts to work along the ground, and you get that thin shot, it's almost in this position, or you get that chub that goes along the ground. We're getting the ball more kind of in the middle of our stance, so the zips on our jacket more in the middle of our stance. We're getting our weight more evenly distributed, so our weight's not too far back or too far forward. We've got about 50% on each foot, and then our hands are kind of almost level with the golf ball. We don't want our hands drastically ahead. We're keeping our hands level with the golf ball to almost try and expose more of this sole, or more of the sole of the club. So if we get the hands forward, digging the lead edge into the ground, get the hands level, get the club more up and down, allow the sole of the club to interact with the ground. So almost in that position, we're not taking much of a divot, back to the old technique where the ball's back, hands are too far forward. From there, if we try and flip, what's going to happen is this cane is going to point directly to the right behind the golf ball. That's generally where your weight position is. So from there, what we want to do is the cane on the under my left arm, we want to get that to finish forward of the golf ball. So that's getting our chest to point towards the target, and that's just going to generally help us rotate better. So think about that. The cane, if we fall back, it's going to point directly to the camera, weight's going to be behind the ball. So think about getting this cane in front of the golf ball to try and get my weight to the left. Ball in the middle of our stance, weight evenly spread, stand a little bit closer and allow the sole of the club to interact with the ground. We're taking a shallow, almost just a bruising the ground type action, and then this cane forward of the target. And again, method of chipping versus the new method. So any thoughts in the video, make sure you comment below, like the video, share it around. So the old method was ball position back, weight forward, hands forward, use the leading edge to hit it into the ground, take a big divot. But this time it's kind of the opposite. So if you've been struggling with your chipping over the years, then why not try something new? If it's not working, let's try something new. They're always just trying to gain a bit of confidence. So the weight's more evenly distributed, ball position is slightly further forward, we're letting the sole of the club do the work to interact with the ground, that's what it's designed to do. And then from there, let's get the cane to point in front of the target so we can rotate our weight through to the impact position and get our body to turn towards the target. Thanks for listening.